thoughts, views, and opinions you hear on this show are just that, my thoughts, my views, my opinions. So if you don't like them, disagree with them, or whatever the case may be, well, there's a simple solution to all that, and that's just stop listening. But if you care to partake in the conversation, sit back, turn it up, and enjoy the show. Yeah, that. Welcome back to another episode of the YeahDat podcast, hosted by yours truly, West Coast Roberto. First and foremost, I hope y'all are doing well, and I wish y'all well, as always. And I know that coming up here later on this year, a lot of y'all are going to be dealing with some devastating loss, and it's going to affect you, some of you more than others. So I just want y'all to know that it's okay. You'll be okay. It's hard to say goodbye sometimes, but it is what it is.
The YeahDat Podcast.
I'm doing this tonight. You're probably gonna start.
Sing along if you know the words. It's okay if you do, because I do. I have a little sister, so I know the words. Shout out to my sister Vanessa. I love you.
I know that I can't take no more.
Yep. You know it.
I wanna see you out that door, baby. Bye bye bye.
Bye bye. Don't wanna be a fool for you. Just another player in your game for two.
TikTok's gone, y'all.
You may hate me, but it ain't no lie, baby. Bye bye bye.
Now a lot of y'all are gonna, you know, persevere, and at first it's going to be tough on y'all, you know what I mean, but you're going to get over it. But then you're going to go through the withdrawal phase, and then you're going to be feeling like this.
You're all I ever wanted. You're all I ever needed.
Man, I miss TikTok.
So tell me what to do now.
All them other apps don't, they don't compete. Shout out JT, man.
It's hard to make the things I did enough.
Follow on Instagram at YeahDat Podcast. On TikTok at YeahDat Podcast while we still have it. Let's go.
So don't hang up the phone now.
Hey, hey, hey. Another episode of the YeahDat Podcast, hosted by yours truly, West Coast Rob. How are y'all doing out there? I hope y'all are doing well. I'm doing well. For those of you who watch and don't listen to the podcast, man, y'all miss out on some very, very good musical intros that's only played on the audio versions of the podcast because, you know, copyright issues. However, the audio versions of the podcast are also uploaded to the YouTube channel, so you can hear them there. I don't get monetizations or payout for those because of the copyright issues, but every week there is a musical intro. For those of you who are unfamiliar, y'all should check it out, man. You know what I'm saying? Depends on the mood, whatever mood I'm in, but this one was a doozy. You know what I'm saying? So, hope y'all are doing well. Homie's doing well. Episode 62. Before we get into it, last week's episode, episode 61, we talked about various things, from the Oscars to other things. Oppenheimer. I mean, we talked about a lot of things. If you haven't checked it out, you haven't listened, go back and listen. Catch up, stay current. And if you're new to the show, thank you for tuning in. I'm West Coast Rob, and I appreciate y'all for taking the time out. And check me out. Listen to the pod or watch on YouTube. Make sure you follow on Instagram at YeahDat Podcast and on TikTok while we still have it at YeahDat Podcast. And subscribe. Check me out on YouTube, youtube.com/West Coast Rob. How are y'all doing out there? The homie here is doing well. Busy as usual. As usual. Just got back a little while ago from running all over town trying to pick up an item for my daughter, whose birthday's coming up. By the time this comes out, it'll be her birthday. So happy birthday to my oldest baby, Killer Cam, the big 1-7. Yes, I have a 17-year-old, y'all. Yep, and my baby, she'll be 14 later on this year. The homie's up there. You know what I'm saying? Blessed to be up there. But homie's doing well. I hope y'all are doing well. Hope y'all had a good weekend. Hope y'all had a good week last week. Good couple days this week, etc., etc. Mine were good. Very good, actually. There was a lot of soccer last weekend. I was out of town this past weekend. There was a lot of soccer last week, and I was out of town this past weekend for soccer. Weather was beautiful, nice and spring-like last week. And then to start this week, chilly. What's going on, man? If it's going to be spring, stay spring. Come on now. Come on now. The only thing I don't like with spring is I have allergies and the pollen and all that stuff be tearing me up, man. So I'm not looking forward to that. You can already see pollen and stuff on my vehicles outside. So it's crazy. And plus, they say we're about to have a crazy, crazy cicada apocalypse is what they call it, where there's going to be an abundance of cicadas this season, the most cicadas since the 1800s. I feel like I've heard that before. I feel like they've said that before when I was in Texas, because I never knew what a cicada was until I lived in Texas, and they were just loud as shit. And you would see when they molted out of their little shells, they'd be an empty shell on like the mailboxes and shit. It was kind of disgusting. But they say this year we're supposed to have a crazy influx of cicadas. So, I guess be prepared. Stand by, I guess you can say. Ugh. If you don't know what a cicada is, it's like a fucking huge beetle thingamajig. Beetle, flying beetle, wasp thing. They don't sting you. They don't harm you or bite you or whatever. But they're crop killers. They're known to eat crops, kill crops, eat grass, etc., etc. So, for the farmers out there, man, hope y'all are prepared, because we're supposed to begin a mad wave of cicadas this spring, apparently. Hopefully not. But yeah, I hope everybody's doing well, man. Doing well. So a lot of interesting things I came up on the past few days. Like, you know, my home state, California. You know what I mean? California. Big Cali, they are working on banning Hot Cheetos from public schools. Hot Cheetos. And I know Illinois has done that already. Illinois has banned Hot Cheetos from their public schools because of the additive factor and the addictive factor that is in the Hot Cheetos. So California is getting ready to ban Hot Cheetos in the state of California. And the bill is Assembly Bill 2316. And it takes aim at 6 synthetic food dyes. The reason behind the ban is because of the synthetic food dyes. Blue 1, Blue 2, Green 3, Red 40, Yellow 5, and Yellow 6. As well as coloring agent titanium dioxide, ingredients commonly used to artificially tint foods, including candy, as well as drinks and some medications and vitamins. So Hot Cheetos, of course, contains Red 40, Yellow 6. They're also found in Takis and Doritos, and these are also found or Blue One, also an additive. It's found in Fruit Loops, Fruity Pebbles, and our other artificial dyes are found in Jolly Ranchers, M&M's, Sour Patch Kids, and Mountain Dew, for all my bros out there that love that Mountain Dew Baja Blast. So the plan with that bill, Assembly Bill 2316, any food item that contains any of those additives, and as well as coloring agent titanium dioxide, will be banned in public schools in California. In 2022, titanium dioxide was banned in Europe. So Europe, they've been banned. There's small third world countries that have banned all these additives and all that stuff. Why haven't we? The reason behind the banning is the FDA or scientists say that the additives affect they say that all the additives are very, very effective in regards to children and their attitudes and their moods. Where is it, man? Where is it? Oh, here it is. Sorry. Consumption of the synthetic food dyes could lead to hyperactivity and other neurological behavior in some children, thus causing ADHD. One of the researchers is diagnosed with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. He was diagnosed as a child, and he is trying to prevent that from children nowadays in California. So if that bill passes, a lot of foods that are currently in cafeterias nowadays, Pop-Tarts, cereals, will no longer be served in public schools in the state of California. I mean, of course, they'll be available everywhere, but public schools, no longer. Hot Cheetos, Takis, Doritos. That's crazy, man. That's crazy. You know, growing up, Hot Cheetos, we didn't even have Hot Cheetos at school, though, growing up. So, you know, times change. You know, vending machines are now implemented in schools. So they will no longer be in the schools if the bill passes. So I know there's going to be a lot of upset kids out there, man. Upset not having their Takis or Hot Cheetos or cereal or snacks. So for all you parents out there, really look at labels. Really look at labels, because apparently a lot of this stuff is harmful. Or it's not. Who knows nowadays? Every video you watch or every video you see on social media, something is harming you. Something is wrong. You shouldn't be consuming something. But who knows nowadays, man? As long as you are somewhat active, healthy, take stuff, consume stuff in moderation, I'm sure you'll be fine. I'm sure you'll be fine. Spring break's coming up for my kids. They got about 2 more weeks. They up here where we live, they have the latter end of spring break. Unlike most areas, they have the early spring break in March. But have y'all seen all the drama with spring break in Florida? Like, Miami came out with the commercial talking about how no one's invited to Miami because of all the shenanigans and all the crap that goes down or that has gone down in the past couple of years in Miami. A new commercial came out with local residents like voicing themselves of how reluctant they are to have people come down there for spring break. It's crazy. So with that, the city has implemented a lot of things kind of to deter people from going to Miami for spring break. Parking has been outrageously high, the pricing. I think they implemented curfews and a few other things. So I guess you can say people are going elsewhere for spring breaks, thus leading them to places like Jacksonville, which Jacksonville, that's my second home. But to go to Jacksonville for spring break? Crickets, exactly. Crickets. No one thinks, oh, let's go to Jacksonville for spring break. Like, who wants to go there? There's a reason why the Super Bowl's been there one time. You know what I'm saying? That's my second home, like I said. You know what I mean? My family's in Jax, but it's not a spring break destination. You know what I mean? But anywho, people have gone there, and it's unfortunate what's happened over the past week or so in, with the spring break issues. Thus, proven why the folks down in Miami no longer want spring breakers to come down there. There was three shootings that happened in one night in Jacksonville Beach within like minutes from each other. One happened at like 7:51. One was at like 8:15 and one was like at 8:30. Three people were wounded and one ended up dying. The person who died was 21 years old. 21. That's crazy, man. Don't know if my man was down there for spring break or what, but it's unfortunate that he lost his life during spring break. Shooters are still at large as well. Rest in peace to 21-year-old James Jones III, who lost his life in spring break due to the shooting down there. But stuff like that is like, man, it makes people not even want to go. That's why, like, for me, now I'm reluctant to going anywhere with huge crowds. Like, I want to partake in, like, festivals and all that stuff, but then there's always some stupid motherfucker who has to ruin some shit. And it's just like, that shit has to stop, man. Like, cut that shit out. Like, what the fuck? That shit is so stupid, yo. So stupid. But, yeah, the first shooting happened at 7:49. Then the next shooting took place at 8:13. And then the third shooting took place at 8:31. And it's crazy because the CCTVs, some of the circuits were closed because they were getting upgraded. So there's no footage of the shooter. However, during both shootings where people were injured, that was captured on the CCTV camera system. It's a shame, man. It's a shame. It's a crazy world we live in. And there's like just clips of people running. People are out there having a good time, man. You know, I mean, it's at night, at spring break. They're out there having a good time, enjoying themselves at a bar or whatever. And people just want to start shooting some shit. Start shooting. It's stupid. Then there was the other clip of the dude a little south of Jacksonville, New Smyrna Beach. 16-year-old kid. I guess he was had some beef with somebody on the beach, like the beach with the water. On the beach. The shootings in Jacksonville Beach were actually like on a little bar strip, on the strip. The 16-year-old cat was actually on the beach, in the sand on the beach. So he's over here, you know what I'm saying, getting into a little scuffle or whatever with some cats. And then he runs up on a cat flashing a gun. Cops are out there and they're like, yo, what are you doing? So then this fool starts running down the beach. Running down the beach. They're chasing fool. Homie tosses the gun and goes in the water. It's like, the fuck? So they wait for homie to come out, which he eventually does, and homie gets arrested. 16. What the fuck is going on, man? What is going on? A lot of y'all motherfuckers now is pussy, man. Y'all can't fight, man. Y'all quick to pull out a gun thinking that's gonna make you a man, make you hard. It's not. It's not. You just fight it out. But if you're going to fight it out, you got to be careful, because a lot of dangerous stuff can happen from fights. I know when fights are getting ready to go down, adrenaline is rushing, and you're not thinking about just like the well-being of the person you about to fight with. So I saw a video the other day that my wife showed me, and it was these two girls fighting. One was a black girl, one was a white girl. They're in Missouri. So they were fighting. they ended up going to some neighborhood or whatever. I guess they were down the street from their house or whatever. So, you know, they showed a video or whatever. Black girl, white girl, they lock up. Black girl kind of spins the white girl around, so she goes down, and black girl's on top of her. She's hammer fisting her, you know what I'm saying? Hammer fisting her on top of her, hitting her. Someone jumps in, then people jump in on that person who just jumped in. So another scuffle ensues. The two original girls that are going at it, the white girl and the black girl, the black girl's still on top of her, you know what I'm saying, hitting her. So then she takes girl, slams her head into the pavement. Boom. You can hear it too. It's just boom, just a thud. From that first initial thud, she was out. But the black girl being on top of her just continues to bang her head against the floor. Boom, boom, boom. So then a couple of little fucking dudes are trying to grab her, or they grab her, whatever. Then they start fighting. Meanwhile, the white girl who was on the ground, her name is, let me stop saying white girl, her name is Kaylee Gain, is on the ground convulsing. Just on the ground convulsing. Like constantly convulsing, just locked up. You ever seen like UFC highlights where somebody gets knocked out and they hit the ground and their hands... So the ups and downs of podcasting. I went on a good fucking rant, and you know, I was reading articles off and stuff, getting my information correct. I go back to my studio and it stopped recording because of a technical difficulty. Anyways, we're back, y'all. But like I was saying, so you know how when you ever seen a UFC fight where a dude gets knocked out and he hits the ground and he's stuck with his hands just stuck? Well, that's how Kaylee Gain was. After the first thud, boom, she was out, and you can see it, but the aggressor, let's just call her, continued to hit her. I guess she did it, I think she did it about 3-4 more times, and she was out. There's other little scuffles going on around the main initial fight, and then I guess they all realized she's on the ground convulsing, and they cleared out. They left her there, and she was left in the street convulsing until the EMTs arrived on scene. Such a fucking shame. Now she has severe bleeding on the brain and swelling of the brain, and they won't know the severity of her head trauma until she wakes up. So assuming she's in a medically induced coma. So blessings and well wishes go out to the Gain family and Kaylee. Hopefully she comes out of this. There was a GoFundMe started, and they've already raised $330,000 on her behalf. So, you know, y'all got to be careful when y'all are out there fighting, man. I saw another video. It was a cholo and like a cat. You can tell who does MMA. They were in a parking garage, and it starts off with the cholo smoking a cigarette or whatever, I guess doing his little thing, I guess. You can tell homie's nervous. MMA cat really doesn't want to fight. He's kind of like, you know what I mean? Nah, nah, nah. Blah, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? So Cholo finishes his cig or his joint or whatever it is, takes his shirt off. He walks up to the MMA cat. MMA cat throws a right kick, a right low kick, takes the Cholo's feet out from under him. Cholo falls on his butt. Of course, Cholo being a Cholo, embarrassed. Cholo pops up real quick. MMA cat is backing up, hands up like nah, nah, nah. You know what I mean? Backing up. So Cholo is coming on him, trying to grab him. As he approaches, MMA homie throws a overhand right, misses. But as he goes down, scoops up the Cholo, slams him. Boom. Cholo's head bounces off the ground. He's out, locked out on the ground, arms locked out. Crazy. Don't know the severity or what happened to that dude, but another scary situation. I remember years ago, I forgot how far long ago, but there was a story. There was two individuals, they were fighting on the sidewalk. The aggressor was approaching the other guy, and the guy who's getting approached knocks the dude out. One punch, boom. Dude is knocked out standing up. Homie falls back, head hits the sidewalk. Fool ends up dying due to the head trauma. So, with that being said, man, I know it's easier said than done, but you gotta be careful if you're going to fight, man. If you could, avoid the situation. Be the bigger person, avoid the situation. Violence never solves anything, because at the end of the day, you don't know the severity of what could possibly happen, especially if you know what you're capable of. Like, a younger me was down to fight or whatever. I was down to fight, do whatever, ride for the homies, ride for the homegirls, etc., etc. Now, the older, more mature me, I really think it out. I mean, it's not you being a pussy because you want to walk away. I know I can do some damage because, you know, I've been trained to fight. I've fought before. You know what I mean? So I know I can do some damage. And, you know, the consequences weigh more than the outcome. Yeah, okay, boom, I knocked this dude out. Whatever. But in the long run, this dude is knocked out. Brain trauma, head trauma. She's knocked out. She's convulsing. Like, now I'm doing some damage. So your little 5 seconds of fame, like, yeah, 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 you want to talk shit? Now look. So for Kaylee Gain, who's in a coma with the brain swelling, bleeding of the brain, she's in the hospital in a coma. The 15-year-old aggressor, whose name isn't released because she's a minor, is now in family court awaiting whatever repercussions. She was arrested for that, charged with assault. So you got to be careful, man. You got to be careful. You don't know what can happen. You don't know what can happen. So if you're going to fight, man, be careful. And if you're going to fight, I don't know what is up with my shit, but I'm about to break everything in this motherfucker. This shit has been shitting on me for the past 20 some minutes, man. It's not fully recording the shit I'm recording. And I go on a little fucking tangent, feeling well. I was like, all right, this is the third time recording. But as I was saying, if you're going to fight, don't record the shit, because you're just incriminating yourselves. And if you can't avoid a fight, avoid a fight. It's not worth it in the long run, especially if you know what you're capable of. It might be satisfying to whoop that person's ass right then and there in the moment, but there could be some severe repercussions depending on the outcome of whatever said conflict was. So be careful. Don't fight. I had talked about two other things that happened, but they weren't recorded. There was an MMA guy and a cholo. I don't even know if that was recorded. MMA dude slams dude and slams a cholo in a parking garage. Homie gets locked up. And then a few years back, a dude had gotten knocked out by another guy on a sidewalk. Knocked out right there. Head slams against the pavement. And the guy who got knocked out, who was the aggressor, ended up dying. So you got to be careful if you're going to fight. You got to be careful. If you can, avoid it. Violence doesn't solve anything, so avoid all that. Avoid all that. Now I'm going to take out one of the things I spoke about twice. Don't want to talk about it anymore. But Trump had a speech a few days ago. And, you know, he starts every speech with the national anthem. However, his national anthem is sung by those imprisoned for their part in the insurrection on January 6th. So it starts off, he starts every rally with them fools singing the national anthem from jail, from prison. He refers to them as January 6th hostages. He doesn't see them as prisoners, which is okay, whatever. He then goes on to talk about the undocumented immigrants, and he refers to the undocumented immigrants as animals. They're not people to me, they're animals. Okay. So then he goes on and he's talking about the automotive industry and how the automotive industry is in trouble or whatever. Then he goes from the automotive topic and he goes and he states, if I don't get elected, there's going to be a bloodbath. That's going to be the least of it for the country if he's not elected. Huh. So what do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? You trying to start something? You trying to promote violence? Anarchy? Like, what are you trying to promote? His then public speaker, public affairs officer or whomever comes back, tries to clean it up, saying, no, he was referring to the automotive industry, which he wasn't, because the clip was played back again and he finished talking about whatever it was he was talking about regarding the automotive industry. And then he goes to say, yep, if I don't get elected, there's going to be a bloodbath. And that's going to be the least of it for the country. Then he goes on and he says, if Biden wins, I don't think you're going to have another election ever. Crazy, man. Crazy. And you can tell he knew he fucked up too, because when he said the bloodbath shit, he kind of like, type shit. So, for those of you who support my man, what do y'all think about his comments? Let me know in the comments section. You know what I'm saying? I'd like to hear your thoughts. I don't know if y'all are aware, there was a monolith, a mystery monolith that was found on top of a hillside in Wales. If you don't know what a monolith is, it's this big metal, shiny beam pillar looking thing. And they've been appearing all over the world. Some of them have been found here in the United States. One was found in Utah, California, and in Colorado. The one that was found in Wales was about 10 feet tall, about the size of a semi-truck trailer, and is at the top of a mountaintop. Dude who found it thought it was a UFO, and he's saying that a UFO has put it there because there's no tracks, no nothing leading up to the monolith, stating that somebody put it there. So, where is this thing coming from? I know the one in California and Utah were removed. There was one found in Romania, and there was one found in southern England as well. Since 2020, these things have been popping up randomly from artists or from other people or other beings. What do you think? And finally, because I'm sorry if it seems like I'm blowing through this, but I don't know when my thing is gonna cut me off again. I've recorded three different times. Main topic of the pod, the banning of TikTok. I know in the comments, or not the comments, excuse me, in the intro of the episode, I stated how a lot of y'all are going to be hurt. A lot of y'all going to be in your feels once the TikTok ban is implemented. So TikTok has 6 months. The owners of TikTok have 6 months to sell. So the House of Representatives last week delivered a clear ultimatum to the Chinese technology giant, ByteDance, who owns TikTok. They are to sell TikTok to American owners or see it removed from U.S. app stores. The vote was 352 to 65. The House overwhelmingly approved the Protecting Americans from Foreign Adversary, Controlled Applications Act, which critics have mischaracterized it as an outright ban of TikTok. Where, as a matter of fact, the bill provides the popular app with a legal lifeline to continue thriving. They just gotta sell. You gotta sell. So, what caused this, you ask? I will tell you. So, the Chinese national security law requires that all Chinese companies, including ByteDance, acquiesce to Beijing's demands for intelligence, in effect, blurring the lines between China's so-called private sector and state surveillance. The Chinese government doesn't just influence ByteDance from the intelligence shadows either. It has a seat on the ByteDance board, meaning they provide the Chinese government with direct influence over corporate decisions and consequently across the U.S. user information. So in 2022, ByteDance admitted that its China-based employees brazenly accessed sensitive TikTok geolocation data to monitor American journalists. This and subsequent revelations make clear that TikTok and other Chinese technology platforms are morphing into full-fledged state instruments of surveillance. So that's how they are getting info and they are watching. They know what you're doing. They're trying to get a leg up on the U.S. by monitoring through the app, thus causing the ultimatum. ByteDance founded an AI academy, and they're charged with aiding China's military. ByteDance's partnership with sanctioned Chinese firms like iFlytek and SenseTime, both implicated in Chinese human rights atrocities, and the Sugon, a Chinese company linked to China's nuclear weapons program, underscore ByteDance's dangerous entrenchment in China's defense sector. So all this, ByteDance is in ties, in cahoots with the Chinese government, thus causing us to give China the ultimatum to sell. But yeah, so they have 6 months to do so. And if it doesn't happen in 6 months, then all the app stores will no longer carry TikTok. I know it's going to affect, it's going to negatively affect a lot of people who've made a lot of money off of TikTok through their own endeavors, their own companies, et cetera, et cetera. So y'all will be all right, man. If it doesn't go through and they don't sell, which I don't think they're going to sell, there's no way them fools are selling, man. But that's going to be the next big thing. You know what I mean? Until then, just take your shit and move it to a different platform. I know it's very innovative. TikTok is very innovative in regards to what they do and their platform. And a lot of other companies and other platforms are trying to mimic and compete, like Reels and YouTube Shorts. So the answer may be Reels or YouTube Shorts until that next big app is generated or created or whatever. So, I mean, we all deal with adversity and overcome it. So you'll do the same when it comes to this TikTok shit. I like TikTok as well, but if it goes, it goes. If it dies, it dies, in my Drago voice. But with that being said, I'm going to end this shit here before I get cut off again because technical difficulties have been happening all fucking night. Thank y'all for listening. I apologize for the choppy episode if it appears choppy or whatever. But thank y'all for listening. Thank y'all for tuning in. If you're new to the show, make sure you hit that rate or you rate the podcast, you follow the podcast, you subscribe, whatever, et cetera, et cetera. I appreciate you for those avid loyalists. You already know what time it is. You already know how much I love y'all for that. Appreciate y'all so much. Check out the links in the show notes if y'all wanna follow the podcast on Instagram or on TikTok while we still have it. Make sure the links are in the show notes. Subscribe on YouTube. The link's in the show notes. If you want to donate to the podcast, the link is down there in the show notes as well. I appreciate y'all so much. Until the next episode, it's the homie West Coast Rob signing out. Thank y'all for tuning in. Love y'all. Take care. Be safe. Till the next episode. YeahDat.
The YeahDat Podcast.